Halo guys, assalamualaikum, selamat datang. Apa kabar teman-teman? Apa kabar sekarang? Kabar aku baik sekarang di Bangladesh guys. Aku mau di sini orang putih YouTuber blogger describe how different Indonesia versus Malaysia culture, tradition, people's languages, food habits, everything. How different both country, Indonesia versus Malaysia. Both is my lovely country, Indonesia and Malaysia. I love too much both country guys. So one of English pute, English orang also describe nicely how different both countries. So let's get started and learn about Indonesia versus Malaysia. Both country, how different? And then started
in Indonesian, kamar. In Malay, it's bilik. Bilik is still used in Indonesian, but means a small room.
Indonesia, Roma, kamar.
Toilet,
Malaysia bilik,
in Indonesia,
office, counter, pijabat, Malaysia pijabat, toilet, kamar, kitchen, tandas, Malaysia yes tandas, bilik ya. Nice guys.
Sometimes an English loan word
something
is used
English
in Malay,
loan,
an older Malay word is used in Indonesian.
Loan word,
word
is used in Malay
in
while an older Malay.
Which literally means sick house. And while both of the words are Malay,
hospital.
This phrase is a
Roma
sakit.
Sakit means sick. Sick. That's a Roma sakit.
They simply say
Malaysia hospital.
Roma sakit used to be used in Malay.
Malaysia hospital, Indonesia Roma sakit.
Except maybe in some regional dialects.
Sick house.
A Dutch loan word is used in Indonesian, while an English loan word is
often
used in Malay.
Times,
these words are often
a Dutch loan word is used in Indonesia,
example,
while in English, loan word is used in Malay.
While in Malay, it's
television, televisi, television, police, polisi,
while in Malay,
police.
Police.
In Indonesian, police.
Very nicely,
he
reasons about Indonesian Malaysia university, universitas.
But sometimes they're not cognates.
And oftentimes, does loan word
tas
bag
from Dutch, and in
tas,
Malay,
bag. Malaysia bag.
Petrol,
petrol, benzine, petrol.
Meaning the place where medicine.
Pharmacy, Indonesia. Apotek.
In Indonesian,
pharmacy.
The word pharmacy is used to refer
apotec,
to the pharmaceutical
pharmacy.
Profession and industry, but not to shops. There were some different colonial influences.
There are
well.
Some different colonies influence
in
as well.
Towel,
handuk.
In Malay, it's
towel,
which comes from the Portuguese word
toalha.
There are numerous words from Portuguese in both Malay and Indonesian.
There are
because Malanda,
numerous words
of
Portuguese,
Portuguese
in the both Malay and Indonesia.
Years. Another example is
shoes,
sapatu,
meaning
shoe, which comes sipatu. From Portuguese. Sapatu is the usual word
sipatu.
For shoe in Indonesian, but in Malay it's not used much anymore. And the word
sipatu.
Kasa
Malaysia, kasut, yes. Sure, kasut.
Colonial vocabulary in particular.
Gentlemen,
I
salute to you guys. You are nicely described about Indonesia versus Malaysia.
Very basic and common.
Different.
The word for tree.
Pohon.
Tree.
Pohon. The word for car.
Pukuk.
Mobile.
This is another
car.
Mobile. Short for.
From das. Short for automobile.
In Indonesia,
kereta.
Train.
Kirita, train, kirita, short from kirita api. Das language.
Kirita api literally means fire wagon, with wagon being the original sense
kirita
of kirita before it meant car. Notice the Malay pronunciation of kirita.
Kirita.
Final a is usually pronounced as a schwa in Malay, at least in Malaysia. A couple more examples. Saya, meaning I, is pronounced
saya.
And pertama, meaning first, is pronounced
pertama.
Wow.
Kota. Bandar.
In Malay, the word kota is also used with the meaning of city, but it's used more like that in writing.
City, kota. Bandar.
In Indonesian,
Malaysia
bandar
say bandar. Indonesia say kota.
Channel, rather than a city. Notice that the final R is silent in many Malay accents, including the mainstream Johor, Riau, Selangor.
Malaysia se bandar, bandar Sarawak. When I was Malaysia, I was living bandar Sarawak.
Bicycle.
Sepeda.
Sepeda. Bicycle. Indonesia sepeda.
Vehicles during the colonial period. In Malay, it's
bicycle.
And related words are the
word bicycle.
Motosikal.
Sepeda. Motorcycle, sepeda, motor. Some terms of address and family vocabulary are different.
Are used to respectfully address a man,
Bapak,
like sir. In Malay, sar, it's
pak, tuan.
Is also used in Indonesian,
yes, Malaysia
says
tuan.
Similarly, in Indonesian,
ma, ibu, bu,
are used to mean
Indonesia
man.
Ibu.
In Malay, the word
tuan.
Is
buai.
This word does exist
tuan.
In Indonesian, but is a formal literary word and is not commonly used.
Tuan.
Bapak literally means father, and ibu literally means mother.
Bapak
and with those meanings, they
means
are used
father,
in Malay.
And ibu means mother.
In Indonesian, grandfather is
grandmother.
Kake, while in Malay, it's usually
kaki.
In Malay,
datu.
Kakak means older sister,
kakak.
But in Indonesian,
kakak
means
kakak.
Older sibling. Older brother is
kakak.
Older sibling, kakak.
Older sister is
kakak.
Perempuan.
Not only nouns, but some verbs are different.
Not only
can,
nouns,
be able to,
but some verbs are different.
Bisa.
In Malay,
bias,
boleh.
Can
boleh
bias,
is used
boleh.
In Indonesian with the meaning of may,
boleh.
As in you have permission
bias.
To do something. But in Malay,
oh,
boleh is used
bias.
With both meanings. Bisa comes
Malaysia
from Japanese,
boleh.
The most widely spoken native language in
Malaysia
Indonesia.
Bias.
A significant number of Japanese words have entered Indonesian, but not Malay. I should note that there's a different word, bisa, in both Malay and Indonesian that means poison or venom. The verb meaning to return.
Kembali.
Bali.
Kembali
is also used
Kimbali. Bali.
In many cases, both words exist as synonyms in either language,
nice
but there's
to
no
about that,
frequency
guys.
Of word choice.
Indonesia
take a look at
Malaysia.
This sentence here. This means, I want to eat something. In Indonesian,
I want to eat something.
Saya mau makan sesuatu.
Saya mau makan.
Saya nak makan sesuatu.
Sesuatu.
In Indonesian, mau
saya nak makan sesuatu.
In Malay,
hendak
is more common. And in casual speech,
something.
It's often abbreviated to
saya mau makan
sesuatu,
saya nak makan, saya mau. Malam itu saya mau.
This means I always wake up after 9 o'clock. In Indonesian,
saya selalu bangun setelah jam 9.
Saya selalu bangun setelah jam 9.
I always wake up after hour 9. In Malay, sentiasa is often used for always. Selalu is also common in casual speech. In Indonesian,
I always wake up after 9 o'clock.
Sentiasa is rare, but its longer form, senantiasa, is used in more formal situations.
Bengal.
And the most common word for after in this context in Indonesian is
Bengal. Sitila.
Selepas.
Jam.
Some words here and there are spelled a little differently. One of the words meaning to want in Indonesian is mau, as we saw.
Want,
in Malay
want,
is
mau.
Mau.
Mahu.
The word for different in
mau,
Indonesian
mahu.
Is
beda.
While in
beda.
Malay it's
beda.
The word for try in Indonesian is
coba.
While in Malay it's
coba.
The word for healthy is
sehat
in Indonesian. While it's
sehat.
So far, I've mainly
just
been focusing on standard Indonesian and standard Malay,
different.
Which are in large part the same, except for some differences in vocabulary and vocabulary usage. But in casual speech, the differences can be much greater. There are numerous regional and local dialects of Malay, and even though Indonesian is learned as a second language by most Indonesians, it has developed various local varieties influenced by regional languages of Indonesia. Me and her went to the shop to buy some food, then we ate together.
Me and her
first, let's
want
compare
to
the
stop
sentences.
Shop to buy some food, where then we eat together. Aku dan dia pergi ke toko untuk membeli makanan. Kemudian kami makan bersama. Aku dan dia pergi ke kedai untuk membeli makan. Kemudian kami makan bersama.
Nice.
Kedai toko. Shop.
Malay, it's kedai.
Kedai. Indonesia. Malaysia. Kedai.
Kedai.
Indonesia.
Kedai is used more generally for most shops. But let's take just a look only at how this different. Might be said in casual speech.
First,
in
the
casual Indonesian of Jakarta.
Gue sama dia jalan ke toko buat beli makanan. Terus, kita makan bareng.
The first word, gue, is a pronoun originally from Hokkien
Chinese
that is in casual Jakartan speech through Batawi, which is spoken by the original Batawi inhabitants
both
of Jakarta.
Country, both Indonesia and Malaysia,
is a shortened and Nascola version
with both countries, nice
together.
Communication, nice friendship. With
Jala
both countries,
means
guys.
Rather than go, this is simply a matter of word choice. The word gua is used instead of untuk, which means for, or for the purpose of. In standard Indonesian and Malay, gua means do or make. But in the casual speech of Jakarta, it also means for, or for the purpose of. Next, the verb beli, meaning to buy, is used in its root form with no affixes. Next, the word terus is used to mean then. This is a standard word, but is used more in colloquial speech, while in more standard
speech, how clearly he described about Malaysia and Indonesia.
In the standard sentence, the pronoun kami is used, which means we, excluding the listener. There is also the pronoun kita, which means we, including the listener. In casual Jakarta speech, the distinction between kami and kita is usually ignored and kita is used, unless there's a reason to emphasize that the listener is excluded, in which case kami can be used. But means with or together with, and this word comes from Japanese. Now let's look at a similar sentence, but in the dialect of Johor Diaw Selangor, where Kuala Lumpur is located.
Aku dengan dia pergi kedai nak beli makanan sikit. Lepas tu kita orang makan sama-sama.
Dengan is a short form of dengan, which means with, but here it means and. Dia would be dia in standard speech. He is a short form of the verb pergi, which means go. Next we see na, which means want, but here it's used to mean with the intention of. Next, again we see beli, with no affixes. And here, skit is a shortened form of sedikit, which means a little. But here it doesn't really mean a little in terms of amount. It's just used to have a softening effect on the sentence. Pastu means then, and is a shortened form of selepasitu, meaning after that. Kitorang comes from kita plus orang. In the casual Malay of Kuala Lumpur and its surrounding regions, kitorang is the casual pronoun meaning kami, which means we, excluding the listener. Sama-sama equals sama-sama or sama, but without the prefix ber. Again, notice the final schwa vowel on dia and sama-sama. One more sentence. I invited him to play football with us. First, the standard sentence.
I invited him to play football with us. Saya mengundangnya untuk dirinya sepak
word for word bola, it's
bola,
I invite him
kami.
To play football with us.
Saya
in their standard forms, these sentences are quite similar, but we can see a couple of differences.
Bola,
in Indonesian, a common
kami.
Verb meaning invite is mengundang, while in Malay
football,
it's
sipak.
In Indonesian, menjemput
bola,
means
sipak.
To pick up, like to pick someone up
full,
at the airport.
Sipak bola. Bola, sipak.
In Indonesian, it's
just
sipak bola, which literally means
difference
football.
In casual
in
speech.
In Malay, it's bola sipak, which literally means ball kick.
Men
now let's check out the casual form
dan.
Of this sentence. Notice here that the word mundang is shortened to mundang. In casual speech, the suffix mung is often shortened to ng. Here again we see buan in place of the standard word untuk, meaning for or to. Notice that the verb main appears in its root form without the prefix that it has in standard speech. Next, spak bola is simply bola.
Play, bermain, bermain.
And again, kita
antuk,
rather than kami.
Antuk.
Aku ajak dia nak main bola dengan kita orang.
Notice there's a different verb, ajak, meaning to invite, which is also used in Indonesian. Menjemput is more formal than ajak. Ajak is used in its root form. That na seems to be used in place of untuk, just like gua in Indonesian. And just like in casual Indonesian, we see main in its root form with no prefix. Again we see ngan, the shortened form of dengan. And again we see kitorang, instead of the standard word kami. As you can see, Malay and Indonesian are very similar languages, especially in their standard forms, which are used in formal and polite situations.
Guys, very nice guys, very interesting things about Indonesia and Malaysia. They are both two friendly country, a neighbor country, and everything almost 70, 80, 90, 95% or everything are similar. Indonesia versus Malaysia, people's language speak, food habits, religion, and the traditional, everything are to same, 90 to 50% are same, similar. Both country, and I also love this both country, Malaysia and Indonesia, Indonesia and Malaysia, guys. People are so polite and good, and these orang putih Englishmen very nicely and talentedly. He described very clearly, he described about that Indonesia and Malaysia. I think maybe he studied a lot about that Indonesia and Malaysia. After that he wrote a note about Malaysia and Indonesia, and then he make a blog very clearly. Thank you man, English blogger, you are nicely describe about details Indonesia and Malaysia, how similar people's tradition, food habits, words, spelling, and casuality similar. Wow, everything, how nicely they use languages, speak, sounds, pronouns, everything. You are clearly described, I understand now clearly. Guys, now I learn about Indonesia and Malaysia more now as well. So guys, all of Indonesia friends, how do you enjoy this reaction video? Let me comment below. Every single day I make Indonesian related videos. If you subscribe my channels, you enjoy everyday Indonesian related videos. So I request you guys, aku sahabat, aku teman-teman, please subscribe my channels and join my channels. So guys, no more today, see you next video, bye bye.